Conclusion. In this video, we are going to see few examples on how to find the amount based on the given compound interest problems. Question is, what amount is to be repaid on a loan of ₹12,000 for 1.5 years at 10% per annum compounded half yearly? Okay, so given is the principal is ₹12,000. Okay, so the years is 1.5 years and 10% rate of interest per annum for 1 year, but it has to be compounded half yearly. So we want to find the amount. Let us see how to do this. Now the principal for first 6 months. Okay, since it's given compounded half yearly, what we are doing is we are going to do it half yearly. That is for first 6 months, and then for the second 6 months. So in 1 year you'll have 2 6 months. So we are going to do it for the first 6 months. Okay. So there are 3 half years in 1.5 years. So for now we'll take the number of years. So how many half years are there? 3 half years. So 1 into 2 is 2. 2 plus 1 is 3. 3 by 2 years totally. So you'll have 3 half years. So the compounding has to be done 3 times. So on the rate of interest will be half of this 10%. So it will be 5% half yearly. So we know that the amount equal to P into 1 plus R divided by 100 the whole power n. Okay, and the principal is 12,000 it's given. Then rate of interest it's given 10% per annum. But we are finding it half yearly, so it will become 5%. So it's 5 divided by 100. So the number of years, what we have done, we have to be done it 3 times. So n is 3. So now we are substituting and we are simplifying. So it's 100 plus 5 is 105 divided by 100. If you simplify that, you will get 21 divided by 20. So cube. So what we are doing, 12,000 into this cube, we are splitting 21 divided by 20 into 21 divided by 20 into 21 divided by 20. If you simplify this, you will get the amount as ₹13,891.50. That is 50 paise. This is one way. Now we will see the next method. Okay. So in the next method what we are doing, so what the given time is compounded half yearly, so it is 6 months, okay, that is 6 by 12 of the year or 1.5 years, okay, 1 by 2 year. Then rate is given 10%. So now we are calculating it for half year, half year. So now interest, you know that, so interest formula is PNR divided by 100. So P principal is 12,000, R here in this case, since we have done it for half, we have to take the same in the rate of interest, 10%. So 12,000 into 10 into half divided by 100. If you simplify, you will get 600. So this is interest for 6 months, first half. So the amount will be principal plus interest. So principal is 12,000 plus interest is 600. So now this will become 12,600 will become principal for next 6 months. Okay, so we are going to calculate the interest for second 6 months, second half. So here the principal is 12,600, then rate of interest is 10%. And here we are going to take only half. Okay, so second. So 12,600 into 10 into half divided by 100. So if the interest will be ₹630. Now the principal will be 12,600 for the second. So the principal plus interest is the amount here. So that is 13,230. Okay, so now for this we are going to calculate for the next half year. Okay, because we have 3 half years. First half year, second half year. So this is third half year. So the principal here is 13,230. Rate of interest is 10 into half divided by 100. So it will be 661.50. So now here the amount will be principal plus interest. Principal for third half period is 13,230 plus interest is 661.50. So totally it will be 13,891.50 is the amount. So in both the cases we are getting the same amount. Next question is, find the amount to be paid at the end of 2 years on ₹2,400 at 5% per annum compounded annually. Okay, so here the principal is ₹2,400. Rate of interest is 5% compounded annually. The number of years is 2. Since it's given annually, we can directly substitute in the formula. So we know that amount equal to P into 1 plus R divided by 100 to the whole power n. So in substituting for P principal 2400 into 1 plus rate of interest given 5%. So 5 divided by 100 and number of years is 2. So 5 divided by 100 the whole square. And if you simplify this, you will get, so taking LCM and simplifying, you will get 100 plus 505 divided by 100 the whole square. Okay, if you simplify this 105 divided by 100, you will get 21 divided by 20. So 2400 into 21 divided by 20 whole square. Okay, now removing the square root, we can substitute it like this. 21 into 21 divided by 20 into 20. So on simplifying this, your answer will be rupees 2646. So that is the amount. So thus the amount to be paid at the end of 2 years on rupees 2400 at 5% per annum compounded annually is rupees 2646. Next question is, find the amount to be paid at the end of 1 year on rupees 1800 at 8% per annum compounded quarterly. Okay, so it's given principal rupees 1800 and rate of interest is 8% per annum, that is for 1 year. Okay, so now it's compounded quarterly given. Okay, quarterly means 4. Okay, so quarterly is 4. So your rate of interest will be reduced by 4. We have seen this in previous videos. So 8% divided by 4 equal to 2%. And the time period, 1 year compounded quarterly. So here time period will be multiplied by 4. So here n will become 4. Now we recall the formula, A equal to P into 1 plus R divided by 100 the whole power n. That is the formula for amount. Now we are going to substitute this. So 1800 into 1 plus the rate of interest is 2 divided by 100 to the whole power 4. Here n is 4. So now if you simplify this, 1800 into 102 divided by 100 whole power 4. So that is 1800 into 1 plus 0.02 to the whole power 4. If you simplify, you will get 1948.377 nearly. So thus the amount to be paid at the end of 1 year on rupees 1800 at 8% per annum compounded quarterly is rupees 1948.377. Next question is, find the compound interest paid when a sum of rupees 10,000 is invested for 1 year and 3 months at 8.5% per annum compounded annually. Okay, so here the principal is rupees 10,000. The rate of interest is 8.5%. So if you simplify, 8 into 2 is 16 plus 1 is 17. So 17 by 2%, and the number of years is 1 year 3 months given. So first Mayuri converted the time in years. So 1 year 3 months, you have to convert it into years. So 3 months is 3 by 12 years. Okay, so that is nothing but 1/4 years. Now Mayuri tried putting the values in the known formula and came up with, so we know the formula, A equal to P into 1 plus R by 100 the whole power n. Now we are substituting all the values in the formula. P is 10,000, then R is 17 divided by 2, so into 100, and then n is 1/4. Okay, now we have a doubt, right? So we have a mixed number in the ratio, that is in the power. So we will see how to simplify this. First, what we have to do is, first we have to find it for 1 year, then we have to find the interest for 1/4 year. Okay, so now we are going to find it for 1 year. So the amount equal to 10,000 into 1 plus 17. So 2 into 100 will become 200. So 17 divided by 200 to the power 1, because we are doing it for 1 year. So if you simplify, you will get the amount to be 10,850, but we want only the interest. So the interest for this amount will be, we know the interest formula, PNR divided by 100. So P is this principal now. So 10,850. Okay, then rate of interest will be 1/4. We have to find what, 1/4 of the year into the rate of interest given 17 by 2 into 100. So if you simplify this, you will get rupees 230.56. Okay, so the interest for first year will be 10,850 minus 10,000, so that will be 850. The interest for that 1/4 of the year will be rupees 230.56. So the total compound interest will be rupees 850 plus rupees 230.56. So that is 1080.56. So thus 1080.56 rupees is the compound interest paid when a sum of rupees 10,000 is invested for 1 year and 3 months at 8.5% per annum if it is compounded annually. Hope you have understood how to find the interest when it is compounded annually or quarterly, and also to find the amount. Thank you for watching the video.